Yo, what's good, guys? In today's video, I want to talk to you and let you guys know the important things that I learned from filming my first short film. Now, if you haven't had an opportunity to check out the short film, it's called The YouTuber. I feel like it embodies everybody who is a creator in these times using any sort of social media platforms. I think it's a vital piece of work to check out, but hey, that's on you. I'd advise you to go check it out. I think it's dope. That's just my personal opinion, though. Anyways, I acted in the short film. I shot the short film. I lit the short film. I engineered the audio. I did everything. I think that that was something that I wanted to do because I had been creating so many excuses for myself to create a short film. I kept saying, yo, let's wait until the pandemic's done and then we'll do it, or we'll do it once I get the lens, or we'll do it once we get this light and it's stabilized and all this other stuff. It's just a bunch of excuses. So I decided to just go for it. A lot of the things that I'm going to be talking about are pertaining to me because I did do every single thing in the short film. So keep that in mind. You might not be trying to do every single thing in your short film on your own. But overall experience, though, it was very tough. Very hard from the sort of work that I usually do, which is music videos. I'm used to setting up lights and telling the artist to sit in a particular spot, and then we just do cool looking things. Now I had to focus on audio. I had to make sure my focus was right because I'm not behind the camera. I also gotta make sure the lighting looks good, and also gotta battle with a 6-year-old in the house for audio. It was very tough for me to complete with all the circumstances against me. The first major thing that I learned is time. Now, I think that anyone who is looking to get into shooting short films, maybe I inspired you and you shot music videos and you want to do your first short, overestimate the amount of time that it's going to take for you to create the short film on all fronts, with shooting and also editing. I thought that I realistically was going to be able to complete this in a day. I thought I was going to be able to shoot all this stuff. Also thought that the edit of the short film was going to be around 90 seconds, and it turned out to be upwards of like 8 minutes once I got the pacing and everything right for it. So overestimate for time and also roll with the punches. It's always going to be something that pops up, and more than likely it's going to take a lot more time than you think it is. The second really important thing that I learned is that quality is not as important as you think. Now, I've heard from a bunch of people who are into narrative work and films that audio is more important than video. And I would say this 100%. While shooting a short film, I stressed a lot on the quality and the overall resolution that I shot the film at. I wanted to do 4K. I didn't really account for the crop inside of the EOS R, me trying to use this 50mm lens for a lot of the shots. I had to just dumb it down to 1080p and just roll with it, you know what I mean? So I over-obsessed over the color grade on the video a lot. Once it was done, I wanted to go back and change the color. It took me a really long time to color grade this project. And at the end of the day, I didn't get any bad feedback on how it looked. I didn't get any bad feedback about the grain or the banding on the walls. All the stuff that I sat there and obsessed over really didn't matter because the audio is what really sells a short film. It gets you immersed in the actual world that you're trying to show to the viewer. So me just hearing that from a lot of other people who did narrative work, I took out the time to really focus in on the audio. I wanted to get the audio of the cereal pouring into the bowl and me stepping down the stairs. And I wanted to get the audio of me brushing my teeth. Like, those are the things that really put you into the world as a viewer. And if the story's there and the audio is good, the video can be decent and the project can still be amazing. So quality is definitely not as important as you think when it comes to narrative work. Focus on the story, focus on the audio, and the video should be the last thing that you focus on. The third thing that I learned is to simplify what you can. I had a lot of really ambitious ideas that I wanted to do for the short film, and I filmed a lot more angles of certain actions than I actually ended up using. As a viewer, as long as the action or as long as the thought of something is implied, they don't need to see everything. Like with my morning routine, you don't need to see me put my shirt on and then brush my teeth and then wash my face and then style my hair and then leave out of my room and go down the stairs and then me go into the pantry to see if I have food. No, like, just simplify it. Okay, you see me getting up, I'm brushing my teeth. Okay, he's starting his daily routine. He's pouring a bowl of cereal. Okay, this is what he's doing at the beginning of the day. Like, just simplify it. A lot of short films that I watch from a lot of indie filmmakers, they overcomplicated with a bunch of different angles, and they think that that makes it look more high quality, when in reality it just kind of makes it it makes it very jumbled for the viewer to look at. You know, we don't need 100 different angles of everything. And that's something that I definitely learned shooting a short film. And the fourth and probably most important thing that I've learned shooting this first short film of mine is filmmaking any sort of narrative piece in general, the majority of it is just problem solving. You can plan down to the second, to the millisecond, to the minute, to the hour, but it's always gonna be a problem that arises that you have to solve the problem for that you have to solve the problem for, that you have to solve. I don't know what I just said. I don't know if that even made any sense. It's always going to be a problem that arises that you have to solve. That's basically what I'm trying to say. Like, when I planned this, I didn't anticipate it being so hard for me to have to focus in on myself in the short film and shoot it. So to solve that problem, I had my backpack and I just sat my backpack wherever I would be in the frame, focused it up, hoped that I would be in focus, and then I just got in and shot it. When I did the planning, I didn't anticipate the audio and me having to combat with my son, who loves to run around the house and scream and do a bunch of loud things, have his iPad on max volume. So I had to film when he was asleep. When I got into the edit, I realized that the microphone on my camera had died, so I had no scratch audio at all. So I had to go in and manually sync up every single audio clip from my external recorder to the video clip. So if it was me talking in the shot, acting like I'm talking to the camera, I had to like literally zoom in on my mouth and try to figure out what I was saying and then line that up with the audio. It was hell, you know what I mean? It's just a lot of problem solving. At the end of the day, you can plan as much as you need to. Planning is amazing. You definitely do want to plan, but the majority of filmmaking is just solving problems, because you're always going to run into one. And before we get into the portion of me breaking down certain frames and show you guys some behind the scenes from my short film, I want to give a shout out to the sponsor of today's episode, Storyblocks. Whether you're shooting a music video and you're looking for a really dope drone shot to intro the music video, or you're doing a short film and you're looking for some transitional B-roll of something to get you from one place to another, Storyblocks is the place for this. They have amazing high quality 4K footage for all of your projects, and it's completely royalty free, so you can use it without the fear of getting copyright striked. Aside from that, they also have After Effects templates and motion backgrounds that you guys have seen in some of this video that we're looking at right now. And on top of that, you can download an unlimited amount when you sign up for an unlimited plan. I'm going to leave a link down in the description for you guys to check out Storyblocks. I highly do recommend you guys check it out. I use it for the majority of my things whenever I need a quick little shot to get from one place to another in my projects. So now let's get into this behind the scenes of the short film, The YouTuber. The footage is crappy, to be completely honest with you. All I have is my iPhone, myself in the house. The footage quality is trash, and I also didn't film everything, but I do have some pretty cool clips that I feel like I can break down. And then everything else other than that was pretty much seen in the actual film. All the shots with me doing the montages and me filming the videos, it's no trickery. I'm using the 120D that's in the actual shot to light myself, and then I'm using that microphone in the shot of me reenacting shooting a YouTube video to capture the audio. Everything else, we'll get to it. Okay, so I have a couple clips here of me, you know, setting up gear and stuff, because I thought I was gonna more so go through and do a long behind the scenes kind of vlog style. But pretty much all of the shots in the office for those opening scenes were shot on the EOS R and the 50mm f1.2 lens using the Sur Magic Arbor Pro slider. I have the attachment for it. I think it's called the Genie 2, which makes it motorized. So yeah, that's how the shots are very smooth when we come into the office and do those intro scenes. Okay, we can go to the intro of the actual short film, which is me in the bathroom and brushing my teeth. And this is how I film these shots. So as you guys can see in these shots right here, we got my tripod. I decided to put it up on the countertop, which is very interesting, but it was the only way that I could get that height so I can get that shot looking down at me putting the actual toothpaste on the toothbrush. So I got my tripod on the counter, just aiming it straight down. I'm also using the Canon 50mm f1.2 again. I used the same audio solution for pretty much all of this. This is the Rode NTG 4 Plus. I love this microphone. I'm using it right now for this this shot right here, me talking to you guys. But I captured the audio for pretty much everything off of this shotgun microphone, and we'll talk about the specific shots where I didn't use a shotgun microphone. And the lighting here is all natural. This is my overhead rig setup. Now, I got this idea, this overhead rig setup for Peter McKinnon. I'm using a 51.2 for this shot right here as well. I use the 51.2 for a lot of the shots in this film. I just love the look of it, especially on full frame. And then right here, you can see me kind of setting up the audio solution for it as well. Exact same audio setup, using a boom mic to capture that audio. And we're using exact same camera setup as well, EOS R 50mm f1.2. The lighting for the shot right here is just natural. Same with the last two ones I forgot to mention as well. The shots from the island and the shots of me walking down the stairs were both just natural lights in my house, just me opening windows. But I used my slider for the shots where I was sitting here and it was moving. Again, the Sur Magic Arbor Pro Genie 2. And for me to focus on myself in these shots, what I did was I would just focus it in the middle of the chair and just hope that it was in focus. And Luckily, both of those shots were in focus, and pretty much all the shots that I got right here at the table were in focus. So basically how we set the scene up is I put a bunch of trash bags on my window to kind of block out the light, the actual normal light. I did this during the daytime. And I have my Aperture 120D over here, and I'm using a spotlight mount by Aperture. I've used this for a couple other projects. The main one being that you probably noticed it from was the Saab story music video where we had that kind of blinds look on his face. I'm doing the exact same setup here. And you can see right here, it's projecting onto the bed. And then once we turn the lights off, you just get that vibe. The lights are white, but in post, I just went through and color graded them to a blue tone. So it looks like it's like a moonlight vibe. AOS R51.2 on this setup right here. And for audio, I just decided to mount the Zoom H5 right off of this light stand because it would be right next to me. And you know, I just use the audio from the recorder. I think that those are like the main shots that you guys would be interested in. All the other shots, like the shots of me in the office reenacting me shooting videos, again, those were actually lit and the audio was actually coming from the microphone and the light in those scenes. Now for the shots of me playing the game, all natural lighting, I just used a window and I just moved the tripod around to a bunch of different angles to kind of get that that feel that a lot was going on when I was playing the game. I think the overall vibe that I wanted to give off with the short film, the overall message that I wanted to give off with the short film to get to you guys is just to do it. I waited so long to film my first short film. It's been on my board for freaking months. Procrastinated, always gave myself some kind of excuse to just not do it. And I just decided to go for it. I had a lot of fears that I wouldn't be able to complete certain things. And it was a lot of areas, a lot of gray areas in narrative work that I just didn't know too much about. Audio being one, angle choices, blocking, it's a bunch of different things, but I decided to go for it. Like, forget it. You know what I mean? If it's trash, it's trash. If it's good, it'll be good. You know, and I'll learn from it regardless. So my message to y'all, do something creative, man. No excuses. If I can sit in my house and I can make a creative piece that's meaningful and it's relative and it's affected so many people in the world, you can do the same thing, you know? So quit the excuses, quit with all the excuses that come to you, man, because they're just excuses at the end of the day. That's it, man. I'm just rambling at this point. If you enjoyed this, you want to see more short film based content, you want to see more narrative based content, man, make sure to let me know down in the comment section. You enjoyed this video, make sure to drop it a like. Also, man, drop me a comment about something. Let me know if you watched a short film. I'm interested to know because the views, they going up right now, man. So I'm hyped. I think that that's dope, man. Appreciate y'all for supporting the film and supporting my vision. That being said, I'm out, guys. Peace.